All right, so two truly elite strikers here. We sat down with them on Thursday and asked them any thoughts of taking this fight to the ground. They want to strike.
They want to strike. That's what got them to the show. That is the path that they are normally on. And tonight they get someone that allows them to fight in their comfort zone. They don't have to worry about defending takedowns. All they have to worry about is who can rely on their knowledge and the striking to carry them to victory.
And he landed the right hand there.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the defender. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Trying to go to the body here, unable to find the target. Oh, nice slip to avoid that right hand.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie.
What a punch.
Just misses with the straight right.
Superman.
And now they are throwing both sides with conviction.
He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Clean left punch followed by the right. Just over 2 minutes, round one. Oh, an educated jab there. I could watch this dude jab all day.
I mean, he's so light on his feet, and when he pops that jab, it comes right back to his face. Massive elbow lands from Clayton.
All right, lands a kick there. Pretty well done.
Really good accuracy landing that kick.
Oh, and he caught the kick. Massive head kick. Oh, straight right. Oh!
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Wow, what a kick. Oh! Try to establish that jab. ...20 seconds to go in round one. Oh, spinning back fist. He didn't telegraph that one at all. Still unable to find that precise range with the high kick. All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
Round two is upon us. Your thoughts on round one, champ?
Round one was a very close round. Both guys had their moments, but nobody has really went out ahead in the race as we go into the second round. Nice punch there.
Massive head kick. And a knee. Just out of range with that kick attempt. Wow!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. We'll finish this fight.
Timely defense there. Huge block for him. Unable to land with that punch.
I mean, he's cutting them down to size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Dig deep, dig deep.
Big kick lands.
Whoa!
He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Three minutes now to go in round two. attempts the front kick there. So a much different approach for him. Whoa!
Oh, he just hurt him. He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got him pulling hurt very bad. Oh, nice right hand.
Throwing that jab, no good. Oh! Well, he gets up again here, but he looks hurt.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to take that finish down now.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
90 seconds now to go in the round. Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too.
Whoa! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
He's out!